Here's a recap of some of the work we did on the exterior of this Pearson Triton Osprey. I've covered many of these jobs we did in previous videos that you can see on the channel, but this will just give you an overview. We have a retractable Code Zero sprit pole here that extends out. And then this bobstay can be pinned to a eye on the bow. Otherwise it can be retracted. The new Harkin Mark IV Unit Zero with new sails. About a 135 Genoa on here. And there's a Garhauer AR40 anchor roller added. Bow chucks on each side. And a Lofranz Royal manual windlass and deck chain pipe. A good size one that will allow a thimble and shackles to pass through. Deck has got Kiwi grip non-skid. There's a folding eye here for the inner stay when you want to stabilize the mast. That's the aft position. And can also connect to this pennant here, which would allow you to hang a storm jib on it. Here it is in its stored position. All new rigging, new mast and boom. Got a whisker pole on the front of the mast there. Three sets of reefing lines here for the winch. Go through the boom. Installed a Lumar Ocean 60 hatch in place of the old wooden framed one. And enlarged. Used the original 6 bronze opening port lights. Relocated the stanchions so that we could add a third stanchion and also have a 7-foot jib sheet track there instead of the shorter one that was stuck. These are all new external chain plates. And these pad eyes here are for the aft intermediate shrouds to support the mast against the pole of the inner stay when it's deployed. And also has some redundancy to back up the rig and stiffen it. Extra forward handrails there on the forward deck, forward coach roof, and a sea hood with a bolt rope track installed for the dodger. We finished all this exterior teak. And new self-tailing winches. These are the cam cleats for the Code Zero and for dual boom preventers that can be taken to block sub forward and then brought back to the cockpit. There's a set on this side also, and for the furling jib. Here at the companionway, we've got a latch on the side. And these 3/4-inch plexiglass boards can be used. Otherwise, there are these security bars. Try to do this one-handed. That way you can lock the boat and still have some ventilation. And in the companionway, there's a stainless track to reinforce it so it won't just fall apart easily if somebody kicks on it. And the compass, depth sounder, and that's the autopilot control head for the pelagic tiller pilot. Got new rudder head fitting and bronze tiller strap. Back here we've got the standard 3-point end of boom sheeting, and this is running through a cam at the end for control. All that is from Garhauer. This is the tilt-up outboard well. So we've removed the inboard gas engine, so that will be able to tilt down for motoring and retract up for sailing. Drag free. And two solar tracker mounts for 50 watt solar panels. And on the back is Norvane self-steering gear. This is the Bimini frame. These fittings can slide up to put the canvas on the Bimini. The old frame dead lights were taken out, and we just slapped on external plexiglass dead lights through bolted. It's got a Dodger combined with Bimini here. Right now you can just see the motor shaft coming out of the slot in the transom. And here are Jordan Series drogue chain plate attachment points. It's a 135% Genoa, and we've got the first reef in the main, and it's a battenless main. Here the three reef lines are coming out of the boom. You could take it around a winch if needed, and then to the cleat. And there's the reefing hook and a tack jack line, so that you don't have to remove the sail slides every time you're reefing and unreefing. And these lines come aft, and they come out the sheaves at the end of the boom, go up through the reef points, and then tie off underneath to those slides.